Hi, and a very good day to all. So we are meeting again in our series of tutorial. So for today, what we're going to see is another tutorial using the Maker Feather AIOT S3, which you can see here now, the Maker Feather AIOT S3 with the Thingspeak. And for this, I'm going to use another sensor, which is the SHT40 sensor. Okay, so this is the sensor. SHT40 sensor. Basically, this is a humidity and temperature sensor. Okay, you're going to use these two devices and to interface and populate the data in the Thingspeak. Right, so without further ado, let's start the tutorial. First, I would like to prepare the hardware, whereby the connection is quite easy. So what you're going to do is you're just going to use this cable here in my hand and just plug it here to the pot maker pot. Okay. Show your line and just press it, and the other end just put it here. So now we are done with the hardware part. Okay, next we can plug in the cable, right, just to power up. Okay, so now we already power up our Maker Feather AIOT S3. So the second part is we need to turn on the we want to configure in the software. So for this, just open the Arduino. So here's the Arduino IDE. I'm just gonna close this one. And okay, first we choose the. So in my case, I already choose the board. But if I have not find it's in the here, and just go down until you see the Citron board. This is Citron Maker Feather AIOT S3, right? So that's the first part. And let's configure the port. Okay, there should be COM9. Okay, then it's done in the first part. Okay, next we need to install the required library. So go to the sketch, include library and manage libraries. Okay, in here we need to add two libraries. First, we will add the library for the Thingspeak. So just type the first one, we want to use the Thingspeak library. Just click Thingspeak and press enter. Okay. So this is the first one from, make sure it is from the MathWorks. And in my case, I've already installed it. So I'm not going to install it again. And the version is I'm using the latest version also. So I'm not going to install it. But if in your case, you have not installed it yet, so make sure you install it. That's the first one. Secondly, just type SHT. 4x. Okay, SHT4x is the library for the humidity sensor here. So the library is this one, Adafruit SHT4x library. So in my case, I've already installed it as well. So let's check the version. Yeah, that's the latest version I'm using it. So that's the two software that you'll need to test our experiment for today. Right, close this. Okay, next we go to the file, examples, scroll down. And okay, first we test run the temperature the SHT40 sensor first to see if everything is working fine. Okay, here's the library, SHT4 test. Okay, I bring here. And let me open it. Okay. So nothing much here to change. So we just try to upload it first. I'm not sure on the port number yet because I've not reset it yet. So let's see how it goes. If it's not detected, then we will do the step to make sure the correct port is selected. Okay, so now the port is not correct. So just go to the tool. Okay, now what we're gonna do is just press the boot button and press the reset button, release the reset button and release the boot. So let's go to the tools again and just go to the port and it should be COM4. Right, so once it's shown COM4, just try to upload it again. And we need to wait a few more minutes basically until it is downloaded. So basically what we are going to do now is just testing the sample code so that we want to show that this library or this part of the code is working before we integrate this with the Thingspeak library. So now you're seeing here, now the code is getting uploaded to the Maker Feather AIOT S3. So it's fine. So I'm just going to press the reset button. Okay. Then I'm going to choose a different port. So whichever port is available, of course, the port is not available. Just choose the COM7 and press the serial monitor. Right. So here you go. So it seems our circuit, the device is working fine. The SHT40 is working fine. So it's time to integrate with the Thingspeak, and we're going to export this data to the Thingspeak platform, right? So I'm going to close this now, and we're going to, before we do the coding for the Thingspeak, I would like to go through how you can set up your own account in the Thingspeak first. So because if we need to use the data from the Thingspeak and put it in our code, then only we can see, so better to see the Thingspeak first. Okay, so let's go and open up Thingspeak. So first go to Google and go to Thingspeak and choose the first option and next. Okay, just click here first on the icon here. And okay, you need to log in first. So in my case, I already created a login page, so I no longer need to do the account. So if you don't have an account, you need to create one before you can start. Okay. So these are the previously existing code. So I just want to delete this one first, so that we can do it together. I can do it together. Okay, so we need to go to the channel setting and click delete channel first. So are you sure you want to delete? Yeah, we just click OK. Okay then, so this is my channel actually, already logged in, and it will come to this page. And what I'm going to do is click the new channel. Okay, this is the new channel name. Basically, we can put it as Maker Feather AIOT S3. This project okay, so first this one we can label it as temperature. I need to click first, then you can name it as Humidity. Okay, so these are the first few things we need. And of course, so come to this window. So if you can see, this is the title, Maker Feather AIOT S3, Maker Feather AIOT S3. So this is for the temperature and this is for the humidity. And so we can add more visual, but we are not gonna do that, right? So this is okay. Now we are set with the Thingspeak, and now we're gonna go to the and open the Arduino again, and we want to see how to draft the code first before we jump in. Okay, just go to file. Okay, so just go to the file examples, try to go to the Thingspeak. Okay, here is Thingspeak, and right, so other for internet, other. Okay, we use this one first, right, single field. We want to see how the code is. Okay, let me bring it here and let me explain it a bit. Okay, so basically this is how it will work. Okay, here what we're gonna do is we're gonna change this one, the secret SSID, secret pass, and then the channel number, the right API key. And here we will change according to the number of channel we'll be writing, the INTX or what. So okay, that's the first part. Okay, here I want to put this one. Channel number, script channel ID. Okay, so we need to refer to the Thingspeak just now. Okay, this is the right API key. So you can just copy first. since it's already available. And a channel number, unsigned long. Secret channel ID. Okay. Okay. So that's the first part. And next. Okay. So we just want to compile this and upload it. Okay. So now it's uploading. The code is being uploaded. All right. So it's almost done. So let us check the, okay, now the data won't be there, but this code is running. So we can see the example there, how it's running. So let's go to the Thingspeak. Okay, I'll just open the serial monitor. Okay, so attempting current SSID is connected, channel update successful. So here you go, the first data here. Okay, so it's received at 448. So that means our communication is successful. So now what we're going to do is we're going to modify the existing the right single field code to so that it will be uploaded to the existing code here. So now let's open the other code. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to merge this code all together into a single code. Okay. So what I'm not going to go disturb the existing code. So I will not save it later. So we just click new code and your window will open up here. So here we will capture all the codes that are going inside here. All right. So now we have done with the coding. So let me just open. Okay. Yeah. So this is the final coding whereby we have declared our Wi-Fi, the Thingspeak, and added all the library. Whereby we merged the two different code which we have tested and seen just now. So okay. Now since we have done this, okay. Now we are transmitting the data of the temperature and humidity through the INTX and INTY, whereby these are being populated in the Thingspeak. So now let me share the Thingspeak window with you so that you can have a look and how it will look like. So basically, this has been running for quite some time now. So that's why you can see the data here, right? So these are the data that's being captured. Basically, this is the temperature and humidity. If we want, we can definitely change the legend, everything here. Just click the button here, field one chart option. Just click here, then you'll have all the options. You can give a title. Just say we put the temperature here. So we put the temperature here. Then just try to click save. And you can see it's changed to temperature. All right. And here we can give the humidity. Just give it a name. Humidity. Yep. So change to humidity. So that's all for today. And this data, the data here actually can be exported or imported as well. And you can have a MATLAB analysis and MATLAB visualization as well. That we can cover in an upcoming tutorial video. So thank you for watching. Till we meet in our next tutorial. Thank you and bye-bye.